How you doing? My name is Menkheperra. I am a member of the Unitas community and family. So here we learn all kinds of strategies about how to invest in real estate. And whether you like it as a strategy or not, you can obviously use it to get money, because you know there's plenty of money in real estate. And
so what is it that you do? Like how do you get started?
Roadside sign. I call the roadside sign. Crazy as that may sound, I call the roadside sign. It was Anthony's sign, and then so Joe is Anthony's five star, and if you come into the community, you know what a five star is. And so I spoke to Joe. And Joe put me through the process. Basically, he had me watch an introductory link. I had been to, I think I had gone to Westbury. Well, that was before I went to Westbury. But
that's one of the locations.
Yeah, there was a Westbury location. It's now in Hicksville. So we do have locations throughout New York. We have a Nassau one, that's the one in Hicksville. We have this one here in Queens. Yeah. And we have one in Midtown Manhattan. Or Lower Manhattan, you know.
And you was working on a deal, right? Tell us a little something about that deal.
So I got I have one I'm working on now. I had one I was attempting to do. I was attempting to get three properties. It's not a motivated seller, so that's one of the things we want to look for, is a motivated seller. So it makes it a lot more difficult when a person is not motivated. And I offer them a great deal, they just don't understand what I offer them. So,
and what was the price range on
it was three properties in Norwich, New York. They wanted $250 for all three of them. Mm-hmm. And we was like, we ain't doing that. I said, so I'd offer them an alternative. I offered to take over the mortgage and then cut him a nice fat check for his troubles, and I offered the realtor their 3% for the full price of the homes, the three homes. You know what I'm saying? But
so what was it? Foreclosure?
Nah, this is just a gentleman who has a portfolio of three homes. He claims he's tired of doing the real estate thing. He just wants to get rid of them. So I said, all right. Because I spoke to Joe about it. Joe's like, offer him $60,000 for him.
$60,000.
So that was my first offer.
So what was his asking price? What was the guy?
$250,000 for him. So we went from $60,000 to $120,000, and then we stopped there. And I said, all right, fine. Forget all that. I said, assign the mortgages to us, and then we'll give you a check. But we can negotiate what you would, because if you pay off your mortgages, right, you're gonna hopefully have something left over at the end. So we could give you that, or we can even maybe negotiate above that. But the dude, he's not that.
He's not that motivated.
He's not that. I would say he's not that bright, because it's the same thing. That's what I would say, because in my mind, you assign the mortgage. There's an attorney that will get that mortgage assigned to our company. Period.
So what's the final analysis right now? Did you finalize it
The dude didn't want to do it, so I had messaged actually the gentleman, because there was nobody bidding on the property. You know what I mean? So to me, he doesn't want to sell it. Because you can't be that stubborn. I want to sell it for my price. If nobody's offering you that price, I think the best bid he got maybe was around 180 or something like that.
So he's not motivated.
He isn't motivated. You know what I'm saying? Because he would have taken, or he would have negotiated the first offer, maybe up to 200 or 225 or whatever it would have been. You know what I mean? Or maybe, because I tried to find out what the mortgage was and, see what we could do there. But the realtor wasn't willing to divulge that information.
So give us some information about how to contact
you. My number is 718-404-1308. My current company is a sole prop called FabTap. I'm looking to get my LLC just prior to my first acquisition. Looking to do that. But I'm working on the wholesale right now, out in the Hamptons. So we'll see how that works. I made bids on some other properties too, but we do it from the investor perspective. So we're not into acquiring 30-year mortgages and all that other nonsense. We want to spend as little money as possible, or a little of your own money in the acquisition, and you know, and then go from there. Use the, you want to use other people's money and then get other people to fund your lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? Pardon me. We work hard. We worked hard all our life. I'm a grown man. I'm 46. So, you know, I've been working for people long enough. I've been doing the dumb, you know, exchange time for dollars. You know what I mean? So we 9 to 5 killers here. You know, we show you how to get freedom. And then the last thing I want to end with. Yeah, exactly. The last thing I want to end with is the purpose of business is this in my mind. Is you build a business, right? And you do all the hard work in the beginning. And then you start to hire talent to do the things that you'd rather not do. And the purpose of that, now you're hiring people, so you're employing people, right? But at some point, you become the manager, and then you can walk away. You build a system, you have others work that system, and now you can go play golf at 10 a.m. or 11 a.m., whatever time you want, you know, whatever you want to do. And then once you build one business, you can always build another, and another, and another. And then that's what wealthy people do. They have property, and they have businesses. And those property, and they have other investments. You know, stocks, stocks, bonds, you know, of course real estate is the key. Because, you know, 90% of millionaires made their money in real estate before they made it in anything else. You know what I mean? So, that's what they do. They have all these investments that are just paying them. And then people be like, yo, they get hate. They hate on them people who don't hate. Congratulate and learn what they did and do the same thing. You know what I mean? So if you want to learn how to become financially free, you got to come down to, if you want that GT2 Porsche, you got to come down to Redondo. You know what I'm saying? You got to come down here
and get that GT2.
Yo, this dude already got a whole lot of money right here. That's why he's smiling like that. You know what I'm saying? That's what real estate does. It makes people smile big like that. You know what I mean?
All right, baby. We're going to catch up with you.
All right, baby. Well, so long for now. But you know what? You can catch up with me or anybody else in the community. You can give me a shout. You want to come down, check out the information. I'm glad to have you. You know, there's plenty of money out there, so, you know, we want it all, but, you know, you can have some too. All right, then.